You're watching the Rickvanman channel, and in today's video, Rick is back on the allotment.
Hey there, this is Rick, and we are back at the allotment today. And it's that time between Christmas and New Year. Didn't quite know what to do with myself, so I come down to the allotment, and everything that I was told would happen has happened. And I don't know if you can see this, but those blades of grass, they're absolutely everywhere. They're all growing back, which means what's happened is from what I understand, is the grass rhizomes get chopped up, and then each little new bit of rhizome produces more grass. So apparently what you've got to keep doing is just keep rotivating it, and eventually it'll run out of energy, and hopefully will not grow back anymore. Of course, the problem is I've got them growing in amongst where I've planted everything, so I'm going to have to go through that lot by hand and just hand pick out any of the grass. So I know people said it was a mistake to rotivate, but to be honest, the state of this place, I would have killed myself digging it by hand. I would have got halfway through and I would have given up on it, because it would have just been just too much. So rotivating really was my only choice. This is so sticky right now, I don't know whether it would be a good idea to rotivate it or not. Or I could leave it till things dry out, but we haven't had any rain for a little while, so it has dried out to some extent. So I think I'll give it a go, see what happens. But I think first things first, before I do anything, is I'm going to bring the wheelbarrow up and just start picking out some of this rubbish. See if I can sort of make a dent on it. And then obviously when I rotivate it over, I'm going to pull a load more rubbish up to the surface. So I think I'll do that, see how we get on. Well, this is fun. I'm sort of rotivating it, but because the ground's really wet, what's happening is the rotivators are getting absolutely plastered in clay, and I'm having to chip it off every few minutes, and all it's doing is like rubbing the top of the soil over rather than sort of tilting it over. But anyway, what I'm doing, I've leveled out that lot up there a little bit more, and I'm going to get rid of this path here because that is where the polytunnel is going to be. Now, if you take a look at this plan here, you'll see the changes that I've made to the old plan. I'll show you the old plan as well. And that big red line, that is the polytunnel. And basically that's just going to go there. And I've got enough material now to make a polytunnel basically as big as I want it. But I had a word with the council and they said it has to be within character, you know, kind of within proportion to the plot. So I think a polytunnel that's going to basically take up a quarter of the plot will be just fine. And I'm going to go kind of almost back to the fence. I'll leave a bit of a gap there, so it's not right up to the fence. And that means that spare bit of land on the side there is probably going to be in shade. Had I given it more thought, I probably would have put it here. But as it happens, I've got everything planted now. So for this year at least, I can't put it here now. So it's going to have to go up the end there. So there we go. I've just realised I haven't got a wide angle lens on, so you probably haven't been getting very good views today. So I do apologise for that. Anyway, I suppose I better get on with this. We're running out of... Clay is on the tiller like toffee stuck to a saucepan. Well, some progress, some disappointment today. It's not been particularly good. I'm starting to think perhaps I shouldn't have rotivated and should have left well alone, because what I've got now is one giant trodden down mud path. What was sort of tilled soil like this over there is just all, it's all been flattened now. However, I have managed to get lots of the litter cleared up. The soil over here is actually, out of the whole allotment, the soil up here is the best. It's very, very fine over there. I managed to clear a lot of the rubbish off of it. Three bags of rubbish that I managed to collect, which are here, and they're just going to go in the bin. That was from up the end there. But ultimately what I've got here is one giant soggy clay pit, and there's just nothing I can do with it until the ground dries out. Of course, the ground's not going to dry out very easily when it's all trodden down like that, so I need to kind of till it. But as soon as I till it, it literally took me over half an hour to clean the tiller up, because it was just compacted on there so much, and it's just been a bit of a nightmare in that respect. So I'm not quite sure what to do. I may just have to kind of sit tight and leave it. I'll get my polytunnel built between now and springtime, but unless that lot dries out there, I'm not quite sure what to do. You know, I mean, it's just literally, it's so, I'll show you, it's just so sticky right now. That's not really gonna sort of come across in the camera, but it is just awful. And if I step over here, I mean, I was almost pulling my boots off. It was so sticky, and you can see how slippery it is there. As I was walking on it, it was kind of hanging onto my boots, you know. I was almost walking out of my boots. So it's definitely not the best soil. I don't know what to do. Maybe I'm thinking perhaps just get a couple of tons of sand and chuck all over it and mix it all in or something, or something. I don't know. If you've got any ideas, that'd be useful. Appreciate any ideas in the notes below. I haven't had a chance to go through and pick out the grass blades down there. I'll come back and do that hopefully in a few days. And I haven't planted my runner beans. I was going to plant my runner beans over there, but it's just so sticky. Sorry, not runner beans, broad beans. But it's just so sticky. I'm not quite sure what to do with them now. So anyway, right, I'm going to knock it on the head today and kind of write the rest of the day off. I think I'm going to carry on and go home and have a nice glass of wine and chill out and catch up with me some TV and slob out. So that's it for today. Thanks for watching, guys. Have a great rest of the day. I'm not sure if I put another video up before Christmas, New Year. If I do, great. If I don't, have a great New Year, and I'll see you next year. Take care.